everybody, it's about time for Yoga Express, so get on your mat, get comfy, and let's get started. Alright, we actually have some white footage, so that's awesome and great. Okay, move this out of the way. So my name's Jen. Hi, welcome to Yoga Express. This is a 30-minute in and out yoga experience. So feel free to grab any props you want. We don't necessarily need anything today. I do have some hand weights just for my comfort level for doing something on our hands. So my hand wrists aren't like this. That's not something you need. This is just something I'm just having just for my comfort. But if you want straps, if you want blocks, if you want bolsters, grab them. Definitely great to have them. No problem. Get situated on the mat. And we're going to take 2 minutes just for ourselves. I also have water with me at all times because water is important no matter what. So I have my weights. I have a block for my comfort. I have a weight for my comfort. I have my water. I have my little safe space. I have my mat. And I have a bunch of pink fluff on me for my sweater, but that's okay. No worries. My pink fluff isn't going to affect your workout. Unless it bothers you immensely, and then I apologize. It's cold and rainy and drizzly here today. Let's take 3 more breaths together. Beautiful. We're actually going to stand up to start. Even though we're standing up, I don't want to ever start the class standing because then it gives you really need that time to just kind of disconnect from what you're doing before yoga, before we just kind of jump on into it. So we are standing. We have our feet nice and wide. I have them parallel to the end of my mat, but if you feel more comfortable having them pointed out, that's totally fine. I'm going to have my hands just kind of on the small of my back, and I'm just going to lean forward. I'm really going to push those hips back. I'm going to have the flat back to the best of my ability. So having my hands here, just a nice little reminder to keep that back straight by pulling the shoulder back and looking down. Now all I'm going to do is I'm just going to slide a little bit one way and the other. So we're in this bent over posture, but we're also stretching out that inner thigh area. This is adding a little movement to our stretch. One more each side, and then we're going to stay here. And I'm going to drop my hands, and this is with my left leg here. So I'm going to take my right hand and bring it towards the ground. So if I can't reach the ground, that's fine. I have something like a block. And what I want you to do with the other hand is you can either put it in the small of your back, or you can open it up, totally your choice. And then release it down. And let's switch over to the other side. Now to the other hand. And if I modify with one hand, I'm modifying with the other hand too. So just because I need some help with one wrist means I'm going to get help with both wrists, just because if I don't, I'm going to add a lot of imbalance. So if I'm here up on the block with one wrist, I can't be down here on the ground with the other, because that's going to be a big mess. So I don't want to do that. So if you're modifying for one, you modify for both, always. You can always work on that strength gain once your issue has been resolved. Release and put those hands in the small of your back again. And let's roll on up. All right, let's do some little hip circles here. And switch it out of the way. Release. Let's bring those arms all the way up and make yourself into a giant X. And then bring those arms in towards the waist and back out. So just in and out. So lowercase W, giant X. Now keeping the hand position the same, I want you to just rotate the torso. So we're leaning kind of a little bit, looking towards one direction. All right, and let's do the same on the other side. One more. Come on back. Let's take this leg and point it, point those toes forward. You can keep the other leg where it was, unless those toes were kind of pointed down a little bit to the side, then we're just going to kind of rotate them in. So we're here. And I'm going to move my block right in front of that foot. We're going to lean on down. You know, say definitely don't have to have a block. Just there because it's there. Turn those arms out. And let's just bend down. And then I'm just going to put my fingers on that block. Keep those hips tucked under a bit. Don't point them all the way out. And then you can look up, you can look down, you can look all around. All right, let's use your core. Pull yourself back up. Let's bend those elbows, shake it out. Let's roll a little forward and back. And then let's bend that front knee and let's bring that forearm down and let's reach on over. Shoulder on top of shoulder. And then let's come on up. All right, let's switch over the other foot. In front. So I'm just going to rotate. I'm going to take my block with me. Put it right there. All right, let's bring those arms out. Let's lean it on down. Remember, hips are going to stick out a little bit. Butt's going to stick out a little bit, but nothing crazy. Oh, so I can put my hand down there. Forgot to put the block there. Right, and then use that core. Pull yourself up. Let's move around the shoulders, shake it out a bit. And then let's bend that front knee, bring that forearm down. And then let's come up and over. Let's come back up. Beautiful. Let's bring those feet both facing forward again. Bring those hands to the small of your back. Let's just do a nice little back bend. And then come foot facing forward again. You keep that back leg where it was. Let's lean it on in. And we're going to move forward in this position here. So you can adjust the back foot if you need to kind of support yourself, totally fine. But we're going to, instead of leaning forward onto this front leg, we're going to lean forward to this kind of like pelvic opening here. So I'm going to put my hands in the small of my back. I'm going to actually grab my opposite elbow. And so I'm going to, we're going to do one side and then we flip it. We're going to do it the other side. So just kind of know which arm is on top. And we're just going to lean it down, flat back, go as low as you're able. Then use your core to pull yourself back up. Let's do five more, so six in total. And resist nice and slow here. Switch it out. I'm just going to keep my hands where they are, but I'm just going to flip them around. All right, so bend that front knee, and we're going into this kind of this space right here. Six and 12. So I'm feeling a good stretch back in here. One more left. I'm going to come up, release those arms. I can take my step in if I'd like. I'm going to take one hand, bring it across, give it a slight little pull. So I'm really stretching, opening this up. Shoulder back and down. Keep going over here. And then I'm going to release, and I'm going to kind of push that hand, walk it up towards the opposite shoulder. Whatever I want, I can try to reach. And then rinse. Shake it out. Other side. Bring that hand down, back, across. And then reach towards that opposite shoulder. And if I want to try to reach, you can. And release, shake it out. All right, come to the center of your mat. Let's bring those arms up. Let's do a little back bend. And swan that down. Bring those hands to around the ankles. Bend those knees generously. Come to a halfway lift and hold it here. Pull those shoulders back. I want you to turn and look one direction, keeping your body still, just moving just your head. Come through center and go the other way. So you're spending a lot of time today with our flat back. Come back through center. Bring those hands to the ground and step one foot back, step the other foot back. This is where I bring in my little handy dandy hand weights. And then we're gonna come in to a plank. Let's bring one knee in and out, the other knee in and out. One more time, one knee and out, the other knee and out, and then drop those knees. Just take a couple seconds here and just swing a little side to side with those hips. And I'm gonna face forward just for space. Bring one leg out to the side. And lean forward and or back, depending on what you need. And I say do both directions and find the spot where you really need to stay. And we're gonna hold it here for 5 breaths. And release. Now, this is my right leg. So I'm going to slide my left hand over. I'm going to take my right arm and come up and over. Nice side stretch. And then bring that hand all the way up and look all the way up. And then come back down. All right, let's do that same thing on the other side. So, and just as needed, bring that leg out to the side and then shimmy a little forward, a little back. Find the spot that you want to be at for 5 breaths. Take that arm on the same side, bring it up and over. And then bring that hand straight up. And then release it down. All right, so you can come in either to puppy, or a child, or sorry, puppy or downward dog, you decide. I'm 100% going into puppy, so that means my forearms are on the ground, my forehead is on the ground, and my hips and glutes are in the air. If you would like to go into downward dog, please do so. 5 breaths, really stretching out that back. Whatever variation you're in, you are going to lift that right leg up behind you. Bend that knee and bring it on through so your right foot is on the ground, the back knee is on the ground. You're going to roll up. Let's turn. Let's open up those arms and let's do the same thing we did standing. We're just going to rotate here. Alright, back to our puppy or downward dog, whatever we were doing. If we want to switch, totally fine. So let's take 3 breaths here. And then let's lift that left leg up behind. Bend that knee, bring it on through. And now we're swapped to the other side. So adjust. I'm gonna be facing that direction. Pay no attention. You'll see my butt, it's a pipe. Bring those arms out and let's lean it on in. And then come on up. I'll bend that arm and let's lean it on in and bring that arm up and over. Release it back. One more time in our downward dog or our puppy. Three breaths. And then make your way so you're lying on your belly. However you'd like to get there is totally fine. All right, so what we're gonna do is I'm going to have my left arm out to my side here. I'm looking right down towards the mat. I'm gonna take my other hand and bring it right by my shoulder. So I have my right hand by my right shoulder. My right foot is pointed towards the ceiling, my foot flat, and my right knee is bent. So this is my position here. I'm going to use my right hand. I'm going to push myself over so that my right foot is on the ground. I feel a nice stretch in my left shoulder. And my right hand can either be for stability where it is, it can be behind in a little bit of a bind, or it can be straight up to the ceiling. Your choice. Five breaths. I'm going to release my right arm, wherever it was, bring it back to the mat, and then use it to help release and come back. So I'm lying on my belly. Other side, right hand is out straight. The left hand is by my left shoulder. The left foot is pointed flat towards the ceiling, and my left knee is bent. Let's use that left hand to push myself over here. And then decide where I want to do with my hand. Five breaths. Release that hand. Bring it back to the center, and let's roll back on the belly. Let's do a quick time check. All right, so we're gonna come into Sphinx. I'm gonna drop that head. I'm gonna turn it a little bit to one side. Through the center and the other side. Come back through center. Bringing that head up, bending those knees, dropping those feet to one side as far as they'll go. Through center to the other side. What side is tighter? Center. straighten those legs, and let's flip over onto our back, bringing anything that we're going to need for our Shavasana with you. So I explained the pillow, sweatshirts, anything like that. I'm just going to do a figure four stretch on each side, and then we'll go right into our Shavasana. So I'm going to take my one leg, cross it over, straighten the other leg, and grab behind, and option to bring that head up. Flex that foot as compared to pointing. And release it down. Reset other side. And begin. And then release it down. You should be in a nice position for your Shavasana. We have 2 minutes here today. Fingers and toes. If you'd like to stay here longer, please do. Otherwise, you're going to come to a seated position however you feel most appropriate. Bending those knees, rock and roll, turning to your side, pushing yourself up. I'm going to rock and roll. I'm going to rock and roll 5 times, but I'm going to sit up. But if you have more time, spend it. Cross-legged for a second. I'm going to pull the shoulders back and down, and I'm going to do one spinal twist one way. And the other way. Welcome back to the center, and I'm going to thank you for joining me for class today, whether you watched it live or watched on demand. Either way, I hope you had a nice session, and I'll talk to you guys next week.